Saregama Karwa 2.0.
Hi everybody, this is Utkarsh. And I'm often asked a question as to what is mythology. I have a very simple answer to it. Mythology is a set of stories. However, these are stories with a bit of a difference. These are stories which are often sacred. Sacred not in terms of religion, but sacred in terms of the fact that people believed in these stories. People had faith in these stories. And that's why some of these stories have lasted much beyond their initial purpose. That's what is mythology. I'm going to talk about certain lesser known characters from Ramayana. We have all known a lot about the well-known characters like Ram, Lakshman, Sita or Ravan, etc. But we will talk about today a lesser known character, but quite an interesting character. Interesting because children love him. Interesting because he had a great purpose in Ramayana. This is Kumbhakarna. Kumbhakarna literally means a person with ears as large as a pot. So Kumbha means pot and Karna means ears. He was the younger brother of Ravan in Ramayana. He has always been depicted as big, huge, both in size and in his appetite. Kumbhakarna was a child's delight to read or see in movies or hear about. He kind of brings in the comic respite in the middle of this huge war. And the imagery is so vivid that anybody who is found sleeping soundly or is sleepy is often at times referred to as Kumbhakarna. But let us understand, what do we know as to why does he sleep so much? Like Ravan, Kumbhakarna too decided to do penance to Lord Brahma to seek his blessings. Satisfied, Lord Brahma appeared to Kumbhakarna and granted him a boon. Kumbhakarna had planned to ask for Indra Asan, meaning the seat of Indra. But just when the words were about to come out of his mouth, the power of speech, in this case goddess Saraswati, played a trick on him and tilted his tongue a little bit and made Indra Asan become Nidra Asan, meaning bed to sleep. Some versions say that Kumbhakarna was planning to ask Nirdevatvam, meaning annihilation of the devas, just remove them, kill them, eliminate them. But he ended up asking Nidravatvam, that is sleep. Lord Brahma immediately granted the boon by saying Tathastu, and so be it. But Kumbhakarna realized his folly and said he did not want eternal sleep, and reasoned with Lord Brahma as to why would anybody do penance for sleeping his full life or die at the end of a life of sleep. After listening to his arguments, Lord Brahma felt sorry for him, but he could not take back the boon already given to him. So he stuck a compromise of sorts and said that he would henceforth sleep for 6 months and then wake up and eat for 6 months before going back to sleep again. This way, he ended up sleeping for 6 months, but waking him from near-death sleep was an ordeal. So all sorts of noise was made, armies and animals were made to move all over his huge body, hoping that at some point he would wake up. Due to all the strength and energy being unutilized for such long periods, on waking up, he would smash a full army single-handed. He was also a glutton when it came to food, and 6 months of not eating anything would starve him to no end. So on waking up, he would need barrels and tons of food to satiate his 6 month hunger. This is the story behind Kumbhakarna's long duration of sleep.
फर्राटे वाला फैन खर्राटे मारे मैन उड़ जा रे उड़ जा प्यारे चादर में क्यों पैर बजारे फर्राटे वाला फैन खर्राटे मारे मैन उड़ जा प्यारे चादर में क्यों पैर बजारे सूरज आथम का है सपना एक चमका है घूमी घड़ी की सुई फेंक निकालो गाने से रूई करना क्या है ये किसको पता है और जिसको को पता है वो करता कहाँ है। दोले ओले सबको जगाओ, उठाओ और कहो
गुड मॉर्निंग,
मरम्मत की जरूरत है
गुड मॉर्निंग,
अरे निकला ये मुहूर्त है
गुड मॉर्निंग,
सपने सारे वो सच में बदलने चलो
गुड मॉर्निंग,
खिड़की दरवाजे खोलो तो
दिल जो भी कह जाने कर जाने दो कर जाने दो, उठो
होगा शायद मैं पहली बार
एक लड़की को देखा तो ऐसा लगा
जागे मन मेरा, उठो जागो उठो कम ऑन।
फर्राटे वाला फैन, खर्राटे मारे मैन, उड़ जा रे उड़ जा प्यारे, चादर में क्यों पैर बसारे, सूरज आतम का है सपना एक चमका है, घूमी घड़ी की सुई फेंक निकालो कान से रूई, करना क्या है ये किसको पता है,